18 to 9. Home Lotto sits 60 minutes non-stop after 9 o'clock while you work. Possible showers today, top of 14. 3 degrees right now. It's Dan and Matty G for breakfast for Launceston's best value and biggest range. Proud to the jewellers. And I'm proud of this guy, Mr. Doug Schindler, for waking up this early. Good morning, mate. Crash Test Funnies are putting on a massive show on Tuesday.
It's pretty big, yeah.
Sold out, too.
Sold out. We're looking at very packed room.
Yeah, Danny McGinley, the Bulldogs banner man, he is great. He's the bloke that writes the banners for the footy team and pretty much is responsible for their premiership last year.
That's right.
Year,
I think he takes credit for that.
So. Well, Bob Murphy does. So.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Bob does.
Ooh, I think Danny's got a medallion, actually.
Does he? Yeah, well, he got to MC it at the end of the match, which is pretty cool for him, but that must have been a dream come true. That's his greatest moment in life.
Yeah, yeah. Well, the irony thing here is that I go for the Bulldogs too, so.
Do you?
Yeah.
Oh, mate.
So I was like, well, let's put it on.
Yeah, well, good on you, mate. And how do you reckon the Bulldogs will go this week? Everything has to go right for them to make finals. They're not going to do it?
No, statistically speaking, I don't think they're going to do it.
Well, wouldn't it be like Essendon have to lose, West Coast have to lose? You've got to win by about 120 points.
Against Hawks in Hodges'
last
game.
There's still a chance, though.
It's not impossible. It's pretty close to it.
It is. But you can't get tickets to that, unfortunately. But how was... did you do comedy this week as well?
No, I haven't done anything this week, actually.
It's been a lazy day.
I'm having a bit of a break, seeing everything worked up till next week. Mm-hmm. And then I've got 3 shows next week, actually. Yeah, so we're going to be doing Jokers in Hobart with Danny as well.
Oh, sweet.
So we're going down there. And then there's cult comedy on as well at the Brisbane Hotel. So.
Oh, cool.
So Hobart get a bit of Hobart Danny McGinley as well, yeah.
Tassie tour.
And what made you get into stand-up? Because your first gig was maybe about a year ago.
Yeah, less than a year ago still. Yeah. So I just went along. I've always liked stand-up comedy.
Mm.
So I went along one night with a mate and I think someone made the fleeting comment, you know, if it's been a bucket list thing, jump up, give us your name. So... You know, I wrote some really unfunny jokes.
Mate, don't we all?
Called myself Harambe on stage. Never looked back.
Rest in peace, my sweet prince. But you've done so well since. Like, Raw Comedy last year, you got one of the finalists.
Yeah, I did Raw Comedy. I've supported Nick Cody, which is a pretty good show, and I've got a few shows coming up in Melbourne and just about to book a Sydney show. So.
Oh, yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Wait, that's where you do it. And you've never tried stand-up, Matty Garwood.
I try standing up every morning.
You do,
yeah.
But you fall out of bed.
Immediately just want to go back down.
Yeah, we shouldn't be drinking that early, mate.
Lay down comedy.
Mate, I haven't had a drink for... 28th of May.
Well, I remember the last time you drank, and we won't discuss that on air.
No, legally,
it was Plucker Duck putting you in the back of a taxi, I believe.
Well, I really don't feel comfortable joking about that. I'm so sorry to everybody.
Drink responsibly.
We've touched a nerve here.
Oh, man, how embarrassing.
But stand-up's pretty tough, isn't it? Like, you either go out there and kill, or you go out there and die. There's nothing in between.
Fight or flight.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's no medium. It's like you have a good show or you have a... Yeah, but not so good show.
And you've had mostly good shows. Have you gone up there and died any time recently? Or is that something that doesn't happen for the Schindler?
No, no.
The Schindler's List.
You know, I had one the other day. I was first off the rank and I was a bit sick. Mm. So I was like, it just didn't fly. And I was like, you know, same jokes at a different show seemed to go well, and that one just didn't happen to hit. So
sometimes the crowd just doesn't like you.
I blame them.
Tell them.
They don't get my humour. That's their fault.
Yeah, the onus is on them.
I did a gig last week at an aged care home.
Mm.
Packed room, absolutely packed. Like, it was great. Like, one of the biggest gigs I've ever done. Mm. And I heard the 4 times throughout the audience. I was questions they were asking themselves. Is it a man or a woman?
And, you are quite androgynous.
Yeah, so...
But you've got a beard.
I know, but so do some of them. And, and then when they did eventually find out that I was a man, they said, oh, you're a very, very effeminate man.
Mm.
So that's probably one of the highlights of my gigging career.
That's a compliment, though.
You could do the next Crash Test Funnies. They're doing an all-female Crash Test Ladies. So... We could get your spot on there.
Brilliant.
That'd be great.
27th of September.
Yeah, cool. Lock it in.
Put it up there with Special Person's Day.
Yeah.
Which is Father's Day now.
Look at all the Crash Test themes we could do.
Yeah, well, that's right. We could get some Aerosmith up there. Dude Looks Like a Lady. You could sing that.
It does, actually.
Yeah, maybe do a bit
Steve
of a Dell.
Tyler.
That'd be lovely. But this is going to be awesome. So for those of you who have tickets on Tuesday, you got Chris Franklin, you got us, Emergency Poncho.
Yeah, and Daniel Walker.
Daniel Walker as well. So really good. lineup.
It's a great lineup.
So everyone's just disappointed that they can't come along.
I know. It's a pretty ecstatic about the lineup. Mm. Yeah, Chris Franklin as MC is going to.
Oh, he's a very funny man.
He's going to bring the house down, and then Danny's doing his only full show because in Hobart, I'm not sure if he's doing the full Bannerman show or not, but he's doing his full Bannerman show up here in Launceston. So
sweet. So is more of this going to come from this now that you've sold it out? As well, like you're gonna lock in someone else for next time.
I mean, I'm talking with Chris Rock and see what I can do. So,
get him on the blower. Jerry Seinfeld's not doing anything.
That was a bit of a fun project, you know. Yeah. I might retire at top, you know, one for one.
Yeah, I'm done from here on in. It is sold out, so congrats on that one.
Yeah,
bigger room next time. That's what they're saying.
I'm hearing that's in the room. So, yeah. Like Book Aurora.
So everyone's just disappointed.
Silver Diamond.
Well, Utah's it's called now.
That's it. We can book those in. So if you've got a golden ticket, hold on to it. We want to talk to you about your Humans of Launceston as well, because that went viral on the internet. Mm. You've got a great story.
Yeah.
So hold that thought, and we'll be back with more Doug Schindler after this on Chilli.
Are you or someone you know celebrating this week? A birthday? Wedding? Your pet's birthday? We don't judge. Register now at chillifm.com.au for Dan and Candace's celebration register, and you could be...
5 to 9, home and home sits. Chilli, 60 minutes non-stop just after 9 o'clock for Launceston's best value and biggest range. Prowser Jewelers, the standard Maddie Garwood for breakfast, and Doug Schindler this morning. Very funny comedian. He's on next week with Bannerman, Danny McGinlay. Humans of Launceston, this has got thousands of likes, like about 20,000. And your story has just gone out to 100,000 people. That's amazing.
Yeah, who wants to read that stuff?
Yeah, I do. Like it's full on because you were born in 1974 in Bangladesh, and then what happened from there on in? Like you were in an orphanage, were you?
No, well I think my birth mother managed to drop me off at a hospital actually.
Oh right. Like
and then there was a nurse there that sort of took a bit of interest in me, and I don't really know a lot of the story from there. And then somehow I ended up in the adoption system, whilst Bangladesh could still do international adoptions.
Mm.
And ended up over here in Tasmania.
That's amazing, isn't it? And it's like a real life movie, like Lion, pretty much.
Yeah, so it's exactly like Lion, I say, except I didn't find my mum. I found Krispy Kreme. So.
Yeah, well, that's delicious. You found them in Victoria. But this is an incredible story. So your parents adopted you from an early age. How old were you when you came to Tassie?
I was 2 years old. Mm. So I was 2 years old and in. Lived in Longford. So,
oh, right. Yeah. God's country out there. Love it. And what was your childhood like growing up? Was it a happy one?
it was pretty good. You know, I think it turned out a lot better than it could have. So.
You're saying like in Bangladesh, they ended up destroying all the orphanages.
Well, that's right. Yeah, they ceased international adoption in around 1978, I think. And so, that's why it's pretty hard to actually... ever trace back those steps because, you know, there's just a paper trail just ends. So lived in Tassie for 8 years. We moved up to Darwin for a little bit and then I lived in Sydney.
Oh, brilliant.
And so you went back as well and checked it out.
Yeah, went back a couple of years ago for a bit of a holiday, went to India and then thought, you know, well, it's so close, it's just next door. So we stopped in and had a look. It was like a... I don't know what Kabul is like, but that felt the same. So it was just hectic. It was just cars, people living on the street, and
oh really?
You know, yeah, it gives you a different, like you had an appreciation of being adopted. Like I always thought it was good, you know, so you know, should do it if you can. Like
it's amazing,
but then when you sort of see that element of where you did come from, that's it was a bit more eye opening.
Yeah, it gives you a perspective on life, doesn't it? And what we have here, you take a lot of things for granted living in Australia.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. I often say to people that we have our vision of what homeless and poor is, but there's another level below that. Yeah. You know? And
it's a 1 in a billion chance, really. That's what they're saying, because there's thousands of people in Bangladesh, aren't there? Like, to get adopted.
Huge population is.
And you've done so well since. So you're a massive footy fan as well, you were saying, going for Western Sydney.
Yeah, a bit of a How Western Sydney this year? Fan. Season's about to start.
Oh, is
so
it?
Starts in October. So I think we've got a good season, good team.
Yeah, excellent.
Good season ahead. So I don't know. What's the point of being a fan if you don't think they're going to do well, right? So. You know, but it's like, you know, the A-League has 10 teams, so it's always a bit choppy, I think, with such a small amount of teams, but I think they're good.
Yeah, beautiful, mate. And also you met Naomi up in Sydney as well. So
yeah,
your beautiful wife.
So I met her in Sydney and, we lived up there for about, I don't know, 10 years. And thought, you know, let's buy a house, but not in New South Wales.
Yeah, well, you couldn't get one in Sydney, unfortunately. Like, unless you got billions of dollars.
That's it. But I'm going on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, so maybe that'll
are
change.
Are you? Yeah. What? When's that? Is that coming up soon?
Yeah, filming's on 12th of September.
So, oh, my God. Jeez, you could be a multi-millionaire.
Could be.
That'd be huge. You can
you don't win 2 million, you can only win one at the most.
Yeah. So, well, you can bet it all on Western Sydney Warriors. To win the A-League, which would be huge. We're glad. That's an amazing story that you have made it out. It's ultimately huge and moving. So if you want to check out the Humans of Launceston page, you can check out Doug's full story. It's an incredible one. And obviously you're in the stand-up game now. So
They'll say the bucket list is turning into a reality. So
yeah. That's awesome. Well, we'll see you next week on Tuesday. Thanks for dropping in.
All right, thank you.
And, we're going to have the new sport and weather and then 60 minutes non-stop next on Chilli.
Did you know it's more?
18 to 9, home line sits 60 minutes non-stop after 9 o'clock while you work. Possible showers today, top of 14. 3 degrees right now. It's Dan and Matty G for breakfast for lunch.